All bears, Rabbi. Step in full to the first, please. Your knees if you can.
real bond friendship. And it's amazing, amazing that we have so many people coming together to tribute to who she was, to tribute to her family, to her children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. And so many people have come out on such short notice. To pay tribute to, I can only say it greatly, it's really what she was, an amazing and amazing woman. I have from about her emotion. I'm going to start off by saying a parashat Tehillim. Afterwards, I'll deliver a few words of eulogy. I'll ask her son, my grandchild, the grandson, to come up and also say words. Then we'll say the Kamalei, the memorial prayer, and then we'll do the actual interment. We'll ask everyone who's present would like to participate at that moment. We're going to start with Parakov Gimel, chapter 23 of Psalms. Bismar le David, Adonai roi thou epsar, Vinos desha yavitzeni am hemenukos yin alayni. Nafshi, shoven dirchani, erkevi magle zedek uman shimo, Gam ki eilet vergeitz amavet lo ira ki anto imoti, Shifta bo mishan zecha imo yinach amuni, Tarok lefonai shokho neget zori roi, Tishanta bat shemen roshi kosi revoya, Achto bochesed yudafuni koi mechayai, Vishabti beis Adonai, the Oret Yamin. The Song of David, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not lack. God caused me to lie down in lush pastures. God leads me beside tranquil waters. God restores my soul and guides me in righteous paths for God's name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your scepter and staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in full view of my adversaries. You have anointed my head with oil, my cup overflows. May only goodness and kindness pursue me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for length of days. We pay our respect today to an amazing woman. It's really paying respect to the end of a certain generation of so many unique people. This was a unique circumstance even preparing for the funeral. I was actually in New Jersey yesterday at a conference, and I knew I had to get back. Because she was so important to this community, so important to Green North Synagogue. And I wasn't able to meet with the family like I normally would. I asked the family to share their thoughts. And so many members of the family shared their information with me, and it was amazing how much overlap they all had, describing their mother and their bubby. But she was exactly who she was. An incredible woman, a pioneer, in many ways a woman so before her time. We talk about the challenge of trying to combine all the various roles that women have to bear. Being successful in their career, being spouses, mothers, grandmothers, homemakers, and Helen did it all. She did it all. She was a brilliant woman. When you would meet her, you'd have to take time. She was so modest and humble, it took time for you to realize how incredibly bright she was, because she didn't want it to be about herself. Getting a master's at the time she did was not a common occurrence, but she did it, and she did it, and she married her husband Leon. They had a beautiful relationship, and she raised her family. She did all that at the same time, when it really was very, very unusual. But she did it, she did it all. If I had to describe the two things that were most meaningful to her, that were the most important to her, they were her family and her Yiddish life. Her family and her connection to her Judaism. Nothing mattered more. I'll talk about the Judaism first, and then of course talk about the family, which was so precious to her. She was a shulgoer in her later years. She wasn't able to come to shul, and I talked to her every week, and she'd always tell me, Rabbi, I'm going to be there next week. I'm going to come. When is Yom Kippur? When is the holiday? I want to be there. Because being in shul was something that was important to her. And yes, I'll say it gently, she slept her husband as well, to make sure he came to shul. And nothing made her prouder than bringing her grandchildren to shul. Partially because she wanted them to be there, and partially, I'll dare say, she wanted to show them off. Because they were important to her. They were so meaningful to her. But being part of the shul was an invaluable part of her identity. Again, at a time when it wasn't so easy to do all the things that she did and be committed to her Judaism, committed to her heritage, committed to her tradition, that was her essence. That's who she was. But above all, of course, besides making sure to always light Shabbos candles, besides making sure to always have the family over for the Shabbat meals or the Yom Tov meals, besides her Hametach and her Pesach Sparim, all the things that made her Yom Tovim so important, the second huge love and commitment of her life was to her family, to her husband, to her children, to her grandchildren, to her great-grandchildren. It was amazing how each one of the children and grandchildren who shared with me talked about that connection, that feeling that she had, the fact that she, when she'd go on trips, she'd come back, either she'd take them on trips. Remember when the grandchildren noted she was 13 years old and went on a trip with all the 65-year-olds, and it didn't matter, but she was with her Bobby and Zadie. Or the fact that the other grandchildren spoke about she'd come back, and they'd wait for her to come back to the trip. What was Bobby going to bring them? What was Bobby going to do? You never knew. But she cared about them. And every time they left, she was so appreciative that they were there. How many of them noted? She watched them leave. She'd make sure that they were safe. She made sure that they were right. Each week when we speak, she talked about the fact she had her family with her. I know that meant everything to her. And I know that after her husband passed, she really wasn't the same. But they were a unit together. They were a powerful bond. I think perhaps if you look for signs of comfort at the time of tragedy and loss, there are two comforts. One, she imbued in her family all the values that were so precious to her that they are carrying on. And the second, but at least now she and Leon are reunited, and she's back with her husband that she loves so much together. Yehi zechra baruch, may her memory be a blessing. The lessons that she led, that she taught all of us, the ability to do it all, to do so many things together, to accomplish so much in her own life, and at the same time, so much for her family, really should be an inspiration and an aspiration for all of us to follow. I'm going to call up Howard to say a few words.
Their quota allowing women to school, they didn't say Jews. However, they would accept her as a medical student if a cousin would donate $10,000 in her name. Mom didn't get discouraged. She fought through that, graduated with a microbacteriology, a master's microbacteriology. During her education in 1947, Mom was part of Dr. Salk's team, creating the vaccine, the polio, at Pittsburgh University School of Medicine. My mom married dad in 1950. She found love. The two of them fought together their entire lives as kids. They found each other. They found a purpose to live together and love each other for 71 years. Being the youngest of four, I never knew how hard life was in the beginning for mom and dad. Dad pushed mom to finish her degree. He worked hard every day at the factory together. They made a beautiful Jewish home. They loved to give and have family around all the time, not just the six of us, but whoever was at the house. The house was the center of summer vacations, holidays. Mom invited everyone, and I mean everyone. The house is on Monitor Street, which I have a vague memory of. I thought how many memories for our family. The Homa Templars continue these memories. When I reflect back, we had a very special home. Even when we moved to Cleveland, it seemed the cousins always gravitated to mom and dad's home. Many either living in their home or near. Must have been my mom's cooking. No, it wasn't that. Everyone was my mom, and she loved everybody, and they all knew they were welcome. A Jewish household with a strong Jewish heritage was mom's fuel. The day in mom's life, working 8 hours a day, coming home, making dinner for her family, somehow finding time to wash dishes and clothing, being a devoted, loving wife and mom, taking care of her aging mom, her own aging mother. Mom has mom's house was immaculate. That is mom. There was many Shabbos dinners. Mom would not miss. Mom made sure chicken was always fresh and plucked, as my sisters how many chickens they had plucked over the years. Mom would be seen hanging out in the second story window, washing the windows inside out. My dad replaced the windows with tilting so she wouldn't do it anymore. As kids, we watched my mom and dad wash the wall before they said, I can never understand how Chometz got on the walls. 1 year for Hanukkah, we hired a company to wash the walls of the house, and mom redid them after they left. They used dirty water and it rinsed off the soap, she said. That was mom. Mom was tough. Ask any of my friends growing up, if mom called, I ran. Wasn't that often, maybe 4 days a week, no more than 2 days consecutively, she would yell for me. I knew always that come when she called, because if dad called, I was in trouble. Being a Jewish wife, mother, and bubby is all mom wanted and needed. She would do anything for anyone, even if they didn't ask. Ask my cousins, they got great stories. And tell them to them, kind sheep to my dad, Bubby to her grandchildren, mommy to us. Mom was this amazing, stubborn, loving woman. As Anita, my mom's aide, made a comment to me the other day. She had learned strength from my mom. Mom was strong. As she started in life fighting for everything she wanted, she fought to be mom until her last breath. Es geht nicht besser heute fällt. A Jewish mother is not better on this one. Love you, Mom.
Mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, aunt, cousin, and friend, my Bubby. Bubby was truly one of a kind. Her love of her family was not just immediate, but family meant the world to Bubby. She was one of the strongest women I've ever met, and when she did raise her voice, you knew she meant business. It wasn't very often. She was the wife of one of my best friends, Zadie, and was a true partner. She managed to be a mom, a wife, a chef, making all of her Jewish favorites, and having a full-time job. I never understood how her walks to the temple every Saturday, which she enjoyed every time she walked to Green Road. Her love of Judaism, shul, and Israel is something that we cannot forget. She was the purest definition of a Bubby. I'll always remember Bubby, how affectionate, understanding, and strong of a woman she was. We spoke almost daily my entire life. I'll miss her famous hello, and thanks for calling. Being 42 years old, I was fortunate enough to have her in all of my life major milestones, and always one of the most important parts of my life. People have called me the last few days and said how lucky I am to have her this long, which to me only makes it that much harder. She loved all of her grandchildren and great-grandchildren, and had a smile that only a Bubby can have when we got to hang out with them. In her final weeks, I had my family in town for one of my friend's events, and even as she was close to passing, She used all of her last energy to sit up, hug my kids, kiss them, and tell them how much she loved him and how proud she was of him. My kids, Asher and Julie, had an amazing relationship with her. And my son, who so badly wanted to be here, has a lifelong memory of the good times with his great booby. Booby welcomed my wife, Michelle, into the family and treated her as if she was one of her own grandchildren. I remember as a young boy playing in a baseball in her backyard, hanging out at Pick and Pay, finding good deals at Mark's with Booby. Every Friday growing up, even Jay would show up. We would go as a family to Booby's house. She taught my sister and I at a young age the importance of family, Jewish traditions, and how to make a mean bowl of matzo ball soup. Although we have not lived in the same city for over 24 years, I would visit her as much as I possibly could. Booby was always my number one priority. It would be weird coming back to this city, Cleveland, and not stop over her house to be stuffed with food or just to sit there and hang out. Anytime I would drive in or fly in, or my sister, she would make sure that we were one of the first people she called to let her know that we got there safe. Still, even in her last few days, as Betty Ruth would come home, she would still want that same confirmation call. Something I'll always remember whenever we visit her at her house or apartment, she would always stand by the window, blow a kiss and wave, and watch as we pulled out of the driveway or parking lot. This was the booby. She wanted to relish every last second she could. Now today, I stand here, I wave and blow kisses to you, booby, one last time. Take care of Zadie. I can only imagine how that first meeting went. You're one of the most special people I've ever met. I'll never forget the bond we had, and I promise to carry on all that you taught me and be the best grandson I could be. I love you.
everyone to please separate so they can bring the coating of the cover in the base.
Handles, everybody, please be careful. It's very soft.
Thank you. stop saying that again.
Thank you.
I gotta get in the car. Of course,
fifth man took another completed the service itself. The actual last moment, or to say one more joke to yourself, or to say it didn't follow by the Federal Cottage. The Cottage has four key notes, and the one that's a book to it starts a form of translation. Together. It is a special cottage after the funeral, so the first part won't be quite as familiar, and the rest will be a little bit more. Yizkadal, Yizkadash, Shemei Rabbah, Yama, Tehu, Asit, Yizkadata, Ula Akaya, Yisaya, Ula Asaka, Lachari Oma, Ula Mibne, Kardin, Yushlein, Ula Shaklal, Yikala, Begaba, Ula Meikar, Bochana, Yubra, Meara, Ulasava, Pokana, Dishmaya, Asra, Yamli, Kuchabriku, Mahuse, Vikore, the Kayekon, Ubiomekon, the Kaye, the Paul Bates, Israel, Ragala, Ubizman, Karim, Vibru, Ame, the Hei, Shme, Rava, Mubara, Yalam, Yome, Omaya, Yisbara, Yishaba, Yisbara, Yisrama, Yisnase, Yisadar, Yisale, Yisalam, Shme, Yisha, Riku.
Thank you all for coming.